The way that the Transporter, the TV series, looks on screen, it's been important to us to reflect the way it looks in the movies and to sort of try to simulate that experience somewhat, but at the same time make it look right for television, because it's a different medium and the screen's obviously different and people bring it into their homes and so they look at it a different way.
When we heard that Luke was willing to give the rights for the Transporter franchise, I was really, really excited about this, because it's very rare to find a brand that is so strong internationally and that could appeal to a worldwide audience, that has an action part and a family part in it, because the feature film has been extremely strong, not just in theater, but also on primetime networks. So that was a big, big challenge to bring that franchise to screen.
I think when Tim Lee and I approached this project, we were modeling the television series after the movies. The movies were a series of three movies, and we really enjoyed them. I was actually a big fan of the Transporter movie franchise.
Well, in terms of a television show, I don't think this is like anything we've ever really done before, because it's going to look like a feature. They're using the Transporter films as their template and just expanding on that. So as opposed to cutting down and making them a lot smaller, they're going all out and to make it feel exactly like an extension of the movies.
The standard and the ambition is very, very high on the TV show. So there's a very big unit that I'm sure you'll see in this documentary. There's a lot of very talented people, and there's second unit and third unit and splinter unit. And so even though we're shooting with a smaller amount of time, we probably have, you know, a bigger army of people to kind of help to, you know, reach for that exciting Transporter action look.
I guess the main thing is just to try to see how much we can actually achieve within a television schedule. We shoot 8 main unit days, 2 second unit days. That's our basic formula in terms of production. A typical feature film would be 65 days, say, you know, thereabouts. So we have a fraction of the schedule, but we're still trying to keep it, you know, as ambitious in terms of the action as we possibly can.
Don't worry, this car's bulletproof.
The main themes in Transporter the series are, and most importantly, that each episode has its own story. So it's standalone stories that incorporate a bit of series intrigue. So we are trying to get a serial aspect to it in terms of having storylines that continue through the entire first 12 episodes. But mostly a viewer can sit down and watch this show, and especially a fan of the Transporter series, and see Frank pick a package up from one place, move through a bunch of interference, and succeed on the other hand. So we are trying to bridge the gap, which is very popular in television, trying to make it a very procedural style television episode that you can enjoy all on its own, but still add some serialized aspects to it to make it a little more interesting for the person who watches all 12 episodes.